I do not try and be funny. I just be myself.
Yeah.
And it seems people like when I be myself, because if you check some of my videos, it's just me talking the truth. It's just how I say it, and the words I use to describe things make it very comical.
Yeah. What look on him to? One bag of questions.
Who is this guy?
Who am I? How me talk so? How me look so? All the clocks and my creep on my foot so?
I am joined today by
White Yardie.
But if you know me, you know I love to do a little bit of a topic of conversation as well, so I thought I'd get White Yardie involved in today's topic of conversation. So yesterday, I don't know if any of you have seen this, but all the papers were writing about these massive spiders that are invading our homes or have been in our homes, because apparently they just like the warmth. And at the moment, they're a bit, I'm going to say horny, because I think I'm allowed to say that on radio. They're a bit horny, so they're coming out and looking for their mates at the moment. So apparently we're going to find loads and loads of giant spiders everywhere. White Yardie, I want to know, do you kill spiders?
Yes.
What is your method for killing spiders?
You have to stand at a distance. Yeah, like, some people got too close to them, you have to think them quick, you know.
Yes, they are.
You have to watch them from a distance and approach them cautiously.
Okay.
You know, like, it's almost like being you know, you watch the lion, you know, when you go feeling free and creep up.
Slowly.
You take your time and just wait for the opportunity and then just jump in the air and just step on it.
So you're a foot person?
I was straight, man, yeah, man.
Would you ever do barefoot?
No.
You're not that bad.
Yeah, for your shoes. If I have no shoes, then I go look for your shoes. And then I have the shoes in my hand.
Okay.
Yeah, it have to be some kind of weapon involved.
But who cleans up the mess afterwards?
Oh, that for me, they do clean it up, man.
Okay, you're not one of them people that you come.
No, man, we can't even the evidence. Clean it up, man.
Question. One of the videos that obviously has stuck with a lot of people has been the Come Dine With Me one.
Okay.
For me especially, my mum even sent it to me and was like, Latoya, this is why I tell you not to eat out of people's houses,
yeah.
Like you just said. I want to know though, can you cook?
Of course I can cook.
What is your signature dish?
Well, that's I do this thing called curry coconut prawns.
Ooh.
Yeah. I can do it with chicken as well.
Ooh.
So, yeah.
That sounds nice. Dinner at White Yardie's, everyone. All right, so you're obviously known because you're a famous comedian,
as far as
I'm concerned. You've got your shows coming up in November.
November and December, yeah.
And December. Do you want to tell us a bit about them?
Yeah, it's my first one-man special, you know. It's called Straight Outta Jamaica. That's the title of the show. And we're doing two cities, two dates. We're doing Birmingham and London. Reason why I choose them, obviously, it's because London has always shown me a lot of support and Birmingham has always shown me a lot of love. Every time I do a show down there, people come out and show me support. So we're doing Birmingham the 19th of November and it's at the Alexander Theatre. Now, the Alexander Theatre is a classical theatre where they used to have a lot of comedy shows over the years and apparently them stopped for a long time. And this is the first time in about, I think, probably about 5 years, comedy is going back in there.
Okay.
And it's gonna be my one-man show, you know. So yeah, looking forward to that. The London show is at the Indigo O2 on the 4th of December. This one-man show is gonna be special.
Okay.
It's gonna be like, if you've ever been to a comedy show before and you come to this one, you're gonna see the difference. This is not gonna be a one-man show like any other.
This is gonna be my first comedy show. I'm very excited.
Yes, you're gonna see something as a comedian that I don't think, personally, I have never seen it. So I can't comment and say maybe it's never happened before.
Okay.
But I have never witnessed it before. I've never seen it before. A comedian is gonna do what I do on stage. You know what I mean? So.
Right, so what made you get in the studio? What made you want to start doing music? Is this a new thing or is it something you've been doing for a while?
Yeah, alright. Music, I love music. Music is probably more, I'm more passionate about music than anything else. Because I grew up around music. You know, my father used to own a sound system in Jamaica. And I was playing, I was DJing from Lico. Like, I can't even see the decks. I used to stand up on record boxes just to reach the decks and mix and talk and something there. So, from young, music's always been a passion. And when we were at school at Jamaica, man, we used to always knock the desk, you know, make beats on the desk. Everybody a DJ and I make up them songs. So, we just fell in love with the music. And then I used to play about with music when I first came to England. Used to always mess about with it, but never really take it serious. And then, yeah, comedy kind of happened. And then the other days, like, then I think to myself, say, yo, I really want, well, not just the other day, oh, since I've been doing comedy, I always want to get back in the studio and just do something, anything. Mm. The thing about it is, when I went to the studio, it's like, link up with Stylogy, I'm saying, yo, come and know him before as well. I'm okay. Saying, yo, like, dog, I need to jump in the studio now. I need to get something done, man. He said, yeah, man, forward, no, we're there, studio now. I was like, what, right now? So yeah. So I got a studio now, I'm there, and I said, look, man, I want to do some music, but me not, because of who I am now, the music kind of have to match with who I am. Mm. I can't go out there and start about some serious things, like proper, certain songs wouldn't make sense for my image.
Okay.
So it's like, with this song, it's like, we just did it and we clear a beat and we did it and I say, yo, like, I want to talk about like how people always ask me why me white and talk like this and we did it, yeah. And they play a beat and then, you know, it's like every minute, how you talk, so, how you look, so. And just from there, so we say, wait, see the song there already, you know, how you talk, so, how you look, so. And I just go into it like that, man. So, you know, we try to make it a comical track as well.
So, obviously, like I said, I was preying you on Instagram because that's how I follow you. And I saw you put up a video of you when you watched Usain Bolt obviously win the Olympics. He was running in your living room, I'm guessing. I don't know, do you exercise?
Yeah, of course I do, man. I actually go into the gym now for about 4 months.
Okay.
Yeah, besides, say, yo, I'm going to be in shape for my one-man show, you know.
One-man show, and for your wife to be.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, you know what kind of shape I'm going to be in, but one of them, whether it's a triangle, rectangle, or one of them, but we are working on shape right now, you know. But no, I am exercising now. I've lost about stone and a half now.
Okay.
So, yeah.
So you're doing it to be healthy or because you want it to lose weight?
Healthy and everything, you know, weight and healthy because even water, this is why I'm saying, you know, if you're up on Snapchat, you would know. You see my Snapchat, yeah, every Mondays I do a thing called www. Wise words with White Yardie.
Okay.
I'm going to just tell you some things that me I got through. I'm going to tell you things what I've been through. I'll just try to give some advice. Like today's Wise Words with White Yardie was about never giving up, keep going, keep pushing. No matter how things get hard, whether it's in school, work and that, you have to keep going. Because those hard things that you go through, when you get through it and get to the end, it's going to be more rewarding than something that comes easy.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? So just things like that I do on a Monday, you know what I mean? So I'm about 4 months ago. On my Snapchat, I started this water thing where I only drink water, only. No fruit drink, no fizzy drink, no coffee, no tea, nothing.
Okay.
Monday to Friday.
Okay.
Because I go events on the weekend and I have bookings and that. I said I will allow myself to have a 1-2 drink and that's it. But it even got to a stage where when I go to some of the events, I'm going to the bar and I say, what you like? I'm like, water. My bottle of water. So for the last 4 months I've been doing this water only thing and it's more about your health and a lot of people have joined me now where they keep me updated with what's happening and that from my Snapchat and that, man. So yeah.
Do you want to tell us what your Snapchat handle is for everyone that doesn't know?
Yeah, my Snapchat is the same as my Instagram. It is WYARDIE. W Yardie. W stand for white, but we just keep it short. W Yardie.
There you go.
Yeah.
What about your Twitter?
Twitter is white_Yardie.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right. Are you on Twitter a lot or?
I'm kind of. I try get onto there, but you know, it's just so easy if you press a video and do it. It's simpler, but I'm trying to interact on my social medias a lot more now. So with my Instagram, with my Snapchat and my Twitter, I kind of work them together where on Thursdays I do old school Thursdays with White Yardie. So
okay.
I set up, I have my headphones, my mic. I'm just play my song them like a radio station type of vibe.
And,
you know, I'm tell people tweet me, I'm getting a shout out on Snapchat and yeah, it's been very interactive, man.
Okay, someone said they're loving the interview. Dan Blake is loving the interview. He's locked at Pulse Radio.
Yeah, man, big up yourself, Dan.
Big up yourself, Dan. Okay, so I've got a couple of questions. Oh, one last question from me though.
Mm.
Obviously, Come Dine With Me was the one that everyone knows you for. What other TV programs do you like to watch?
MasterChef.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I like watch MasterChef, man. I find that very interesting. I forgot the guy with me, Marco, Pierre White, however.
Yes,
I want to go to one of the restaurants and see if he can cook really, you know.
Okay.
I mean, I go review him food, man. I go see on there if he cook good. I go tell him, guys,
Can I just say, that would be absolutely, you need to do that,
No, we're planning, that's something down the line coming. White Yardie reviewing food. I plan to go to a lot of restaurants and eat their food and then review with how I feel it was done.
Okay.
But I'm kind of scared because my life, see when the food are cooked up.
Right.
Like, see with me, yeah? You know when you go like carnival and festivals and everything there?
Mm.
How me judge where me buy my food, you know? Is when me see the most people line up, you know? Mm.
Okay.
Me know the point, some people then we see a long line and then we see some known lines and they be like, oh, they'll take too long, but yeah, so no. And I'm trying not along, there must be a reason why.
Why that is such
everybody
a long
are
weird line.
Over there, so food must go.
Which is very, very true.
Yeah.
I like that.
Some girl go, them wish them look good like me. You got me hairdresser, look for me here, it look good. Me the man one, that's why them vex. You got me baby father, I mean love under you. Me have my awesome in a catch up people yard like some dirty girl. Big up to me five beautiful children and them better sleep right now. I hear some girl a chat, them can't chat to me cause them a crutching. I'm own a thing, so me come and dance, me buy me own a drink. Some girl come and dance and I buy and a drink, them thirsty like. Me have me house and care, so me don't want to some girl. Make them go, them catch up people yard every night.
Hey, you're here with your girl Latoya Lovell, and I am joined by two special people right now. Well, one special person and one co-host, a stranger for a little bit.
Yeah, who's the special person? We need to get that straight.
Well, now I'm going to get myself in some trouble right now, people. Boss 88 Radio fights over here. So I'm going to say my special person can be Erica Boo. White Yardie is actually engaged, so he can't be my special person. And plus, I have a bae who might actually be upset if I call someone else my special person. That is Mel. And I have my co-host, White Yardie.
Yay!
Can you do some more sound effects, please, Erica? I like if you know us over here at Pulse, then we are having nothing but fun over in the studio. I just put on a bit of guests featuring Gigs Gas Mark 9 because we were having a nice conversation about UK and grime, and people were obviously having a little bit of a battle, weren't we, White Yardie?
Yeah, that it'd be nice to see some healthy competition, you know?
Some healthy competition.
Yeah, I'd like to see that.
That's what we want to do. White Yardie, I have some people that would like a shout out. Their names are Jay Delicious and Hannah Rosa. Do you mind giving them a shout out? And Jay Delicious is like delicious, but
Jay Delicious.
Hannah Rosa.
What? Double barrel name, then we're going with, hey, big up Jay Delicious and Hannah Rosa, big up in the surf, you don't know, locked in right now. Yeah.
Right, okay, so we've got some questions from some of the fans that we'd like to obviously get you to answer. Dean, one of our regular listeners, asks, did you always want to be a comedian?
No.
No.
Honestly.
So
no.
So what made you make the transition?
Comedy kind of just happened to me. It was never planned. I wouldn't consider myself being that class clown. Because most comics always say, yeah, back in school I was a class clown. No, I wasn't that class clown. After school I still wasn't a clown. You know what I mean? It's just like, even though I'm not a clown, just put that out, still not a clown. It just happened, man, you know, like, we started some, it was actually Keek, you remember the app, there's an app called Keek?
Yeah.
That's the first app I downloaded, and it's because people were on it, posting up videos and that, and I said, yo, go check it out, and I had to sign in, get an account, so I got an account, and I put W Yardie, that's where it all started, from the W Yardie, White Yardie. Okay. Everyone called, basically with the name White Yardie, when I first come to England, I was living in South London, and my friends and that used to call me Yardie. But there was also another Yardie. So there's two of us that call Yardie. So when they're talking, they'll be like, yo, Yardie, man, which one? And they'll be like, White Yardie. So then it just stick on from there, so White Yardie. Even though they just call me Yardie anyway. But when they're describing me to people, they say White Yardie. So the name kind of from there just grew. I started doing some videos. And my videos that I was doing on Keek was just me talking about real things like, when this happened, when people do this, when people smoke and drink coffee, when they need to walk with mouthwash because, you know what I mean? Like, them combination, they together is not good.
Yeah.
You understand? Anyone talking and people fears, no, you need to take coffee stuff. Just things like that we used to talk about, and people's like, no, you're funny, man. Like, you should do stand up.
Okay.
I said, alright, cool, never try it. And then it's just so, it's more through the people them liking my videos and giving me that encouragement to do it. And I tested it out and it just worked for me. And then the first time I did comedy, there was some promoters there and they called me for the next show. And I did go there, come for the next show. I did go there, come for the next show. Because I miss like payment time now.
Your gift was like, it was natural. Was it something you was trying to do?
Yeah, like for me, funny enough, even somebody asked me like where I get the ideas for your videos and that. And I think I do not try and be funny. I just be myself.
Yeah.
And it seems people like when I be myself, because if you check some of my videos, it's just me talking the truth.
That's really good, you know, because I'm following your Snapchat and like I was thinking like, White Yardie, I'm gonna get some joke, but like you're funny, but you're kind of deep at the same time.
Yeah, exactly. That's the thing. I am comedy is a job, really, isn't it? When you take it out, it's a job. And if you as I say, follow me on Snapchat, and you know I do the wise words of White Yardie and that, and that's every Monday without fail. I do that.
Mm-hmm.
I try to motivate people. People ask me questions like. Can you give me some advice on like there's this guy I like, but he's not telling me if he likes me or not. We've been talking like a month now, but this she don't know where it's going, and she don't know what to do. Could you help me? Like, should I text him and tell him how I feel, or what? But the thing is, he's a bit of an Instagram guy. And first thing he said, I am in a relationship. In case it's me, and I don't know you, so me not talking to you. Like I wasn't talking to you, so if you're fishing to find a way, like, you know, she's like, no, it's someone, it's different. No, it's actually someone I know. I'm saying, cool. I'm saying, well, that's brick. No, I said, look, man, if it's an Instagram guy and you've been talking with him and he's not told you, there could be a few reasons. Maybe he's not interested in you. Maybe he don't see you like that in that way. Maybe he does like you, and because he's a bit of an Instagram guy, he likes the attention you're getting, he don't want to hurt you.
Yeah.
So yeah, you can look at it many ways, but just be honest. Tell the man what you feel and see what happens. Just...
Okay, Dean also asks, how do people react when they hear your patois accent for the first time?
All different ways, man. All different ways. You know, like, it's crazy, man. You know, them look surprised, and them eyes just open up wide like a book. Like, staring, you know. But certain people, I think them look and they're not sure, you know what I mean? Because even Jamaican sometimes over here ask me, I say, yo, which part of Jamaica you come from? When you know, say you have a whole different type of mix up over there. You understand what I mean? Some people question it and them start quiz it, like, which part you come from, Jamaica. You start tell them, and them ask more and more, and it's like,
just
yo, like,
hunting.
Wait, where you try fish for? Because in the idea, it is what it is, this is how I talk. Me now put it on, me now pretend, you get me? Like, if they are pretend, then eventually something would have come out by now.
Yes,
look how long me out, and how come I've been out for 3 years and no one has known me before that to say, yo, I used to go to school with him in Essex.
I like that.
Well, I'm a school friend them there. Yeah? No, like, you know what I mean? Like, people are questioning it, like, where my school friend them there? Like, come on, man.
I must admit, I do like hearing you try and do an English accent though. That makes me laugh.
You know what it is? I try my best. To be honest, even when I'm doing comedy now, if you listen to how I talk, I kind of break it down a bit slower now. Because when I start talking proper Jamaican patois, I'm going to it like this, and some people don't understand me. Right now, people listen to radio and think they're tuning to a different channel. Because Jamaicans, we do not have commas, we do not have full stops, we do not have brackets. It's just one sentence is one word.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So I have learned over the years by doing comedy is that when you perform on stage, break it down into segments. Like, look up, break it down, take a break, slow down the words. You know, like certain words, even get the syllables all out so them can hear every word they say. But with English accent, even when we speak it, people don't question it. You know, I've been living here like 13 years now. So people question it when we speak like English, my best English accent, them question, and say,
are you going to try and do one?
Not try right now. People proper try to question it, and then hear, they be like, I can still hear something in your voice. Like, it doesn't sound.
It's not that you sound to me, when you've done it, you sound like the Americans when they try to mimic us. So that's why, for me, it does sound authentic. Like, you do not sound English to me.
Oh, wow, shoot down.
No, I just mean it sounds like Queen's English, and I don't feel like we sound like that.
Yeah. No, the thing is, in Jamaica, you know, people speak like more. Your teachers, like, our teachers, they speak good English, but it don't sound like British English.
Yeah.
It sound like Jamaican English, you know what I mean? It's more of a slower talking and words. So even Usain Bolt, have you heard Usain Bolt do an interview? When you see Usain Bolt do an interview, you know, the man sound like he come from somewhere America, you know? The man no sound like a Jamaican. One time I say, you no Jamaica, you're born and grow, where you find that accent there? You know what I mean? But no, like, it's just because, obviously, as Jamaicans, we want to when we're doing it, presenting ourselves to the world and talking to people, and like we want people to see that we don't just sit on and sound like we cannot speak properly, you know. We know if we present ourselves well in interviews and everything, you know.
Mm-hmm. Natalie Bannerman, as a lover of black culture, what's your thoughts on the call to ban Notting Hill due to the violence?
Foolishness, that.
end of.
Foolishness, that. Them cannot ban it. All it is the people them will live around there want ban it. That's all it is. Camigo Carnival and me see all people have a ban, which is cool, them and protect them property and that, but come on, man, like, you cannot stop something like this, man. It's been going on for years. I same thing, right? They must say violence and knife carrying and all this happens there, whatever. The percentage was so low. Like, when there's 2 million people at Carnival, I reckon, around 2 million people. The percentage of, it was like 400 and something arrests.
Mm-hmm.
Out of 2 million?
Yes, that's not a lot.
What is that?
Yeah, that's
then
nothing.
You look at Glastonbury, yeah? Glastonbury, they had, I think it was, maybe 100,000. And they had something like over 200, maybe 200 arrests or something like, maybe. But their percentage was higher to
then
their
what?
Crowd.
Mm-hmm.
But them not talk about shutting that down.
Mm-hmm.
Them can't do it, man. It's not gonna happen. That brings in too much income and too much money into this country. They would not stop it because people fly from all over the world to come to Notting Hill.
Yeah,
it's the second biggest carnival, you know.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
After Trinidad, it's then Notting Hill. You wouldn't believe it because other places have carnival in the Caribbean, but it's the second biggest.
Yeah.
What carnivals have you been to?
Oh, I've been to Jamaica one when I was living out there, but been only to Notting Hill Carnival. So.
Okay.
But I want to go to Trinidad one. I want to look nice.
I'm going in February, you know.
Is it?
Yes.
I want to go.
I might be climbing in her suitcase.
I want to go Brazil one too. Brazil one.
Yeah.
Brazil one look.
See,
proper.
I like the look of Brazil, but everyone keeps saying to me, Brazil, you're going to get robbed.
Do you know what it is? I think with Brazil, they don't do as much soca. Theirs is more kind of like, it's like a show kind of thing.
Yeah, it's like
Trinidad,
a street
like,
one. Yeah,
yeah, yeah. But Brazil the one, that's gonna be big.
Trinidad, I heard you have to be very careful though. I don't know if you'd be able to go engaged to Trinidad. I've heard the girls are crazy.
It's wild. Yeah. I'll show you pictures.
She's like, I'll show you pictures. Like, I'm not saying anything.
But next year, Notting Hill Carnival, I actually might have a float. I'm gonna think about getting a float.
I'm jumping.
I'm coming. We're coming.
I was on a float this year.
Yeah.
I got invited to be on the float on the Monday and it was good, it was cool. But you see me how I am as a person, it's crazy. Like if I do something, whether it's a booking or invite to get something done, and it's something like I enjoy doing, but I see faults in it, I go do it and fix them faults.
Yeah.
So I know the float was alright, it was run good.
Right, creepily said big up man like White Yardie.
Yeah man.
And Mr. JP has said, shout out yourself on White Yardie, ask him if he managed to get the message to Elliot about that curry goat.
Oh my god, that's so funny!
did you actually get
the message
to Elliot?
Listen, let me tell you something, yeah? It is so crazy, some of my videos there, like they go viral, like, especially because if I do some Snapchat videos, I put them on my Facebook because I know that people are always asking me, put it on your Facebook so we can share it and everything. That. There was people, yeah, sending me pictures of them, of videos of them in Milton Keynes driving around. So we look for Elliot. No! Elliot has tried to put bad name on. We have to find Elliot. There's no doubt Elliot has seen that video. You know,
like, sorry, I've got someone on the phone for you, White Yardie.
Yeah?
Hi, this is Athena, I think her name is.
Alright, what motivates me? Started to do this comedy thing properly, like as a career, full time. This is what I do. It's more my family, you know, like my son, it's him that's motivating me, you know, because he's so proud of what I am doing. And it's like, because he's so proud of what I'm doing, I don't want to do anything wrong. So even my son, like, he's gone on holiday, you know, he's gone to, I'm gone to Cyprus for a week, you know, like my partner, she finished university, she was studying to be a midwife.
Okay.
So she just finished last week, and as a gift, I booked them a flight to go away, you know, before him go back to school as well. So look, go here, enjoy yourself for a week. So I'm going away for a week, and she's saying that he's singing my song on the plane. You know what I mean? It's like all the things that he's so proud of me is that he motivates me to keep going and never stop, you understand? And also the people, like, people that come out and show me love, because a lot of people don't see certain things, because if you don't follow me on social media, you won't see. But I do most of my promo myself. I am out and about in the streets selling tickets myself. I let people know, look, man, you can come meet me and get your tickets. You understand?
People must love that.
Yeah, because you get a chance to meet me and talk to me. People surprised, because some people might feel like I was in Birmingham on Friday and Saturday doing ticket runs.
Yeah.
And people came expecting to see maybe me, a team, security. It was just me on my own.
Yeah.
And you know, I just do it. My family motivate me, man, and the people them that.
Step to the bar, me buy my drinks. Me see a pretty girl, me give her two winks. For the whole night, she think me speak at me. As me talk one question, she ask me. How me talk so? How me look so? All the clocks, them a creep on my foot so? Are the same question, them a ask me. Is me a English or me a Yardie? How me talk so? How me look so?